The Titans men's soccer team is in a must-win situation if they're to remain in playoff contention this season. But tonight's opponent, ASA Miami, would love to play spoiler. Live from the Titan Soccer Complex on the Eastern Florida Melbourne campus, it's the Titans and the Silver Storm next. Nice, mild October evening shaping up for soccer in Melbourne, where tonight Eastern Florida State College will play ASA College of Miami for the third and final time this season. Good evening and welcome, everybody. Alongside MLS veteran Eddie Rodriguez, I'm Jeff Radcliffe. Thanks for tuning in once again for Titan Soccer on WEFS. Well, Eddie, you and I were on the call a couple of nights ago. Very tough result against Daytona State College, a 4-1 defeat for Eastern Florida. Not only now do they need to win tonight, but really need to look good doing it against a team that they've scored four goals on twice before.
That's right, Jeff. They definitely need to be consistent tonight. They need to win. They need to do it by a big margin. They need to get that goal average up. And, of course, they're going to play again a team from Miami that, if I would have to use one word, it's organization. Last time they were here, they gave up a few soft goals. They've been ahead in some of the head-to-head games against Daytona, and they just managed to implode, if you will, and just give up some of those late goals. So for them, it's a matter of can they put it together for 90 minutes and not just for 20 or 30.
As far as the playoff scenarios, you've got Daytona State playing Broward simultaneously tonight down in Pembroke Pines. Should Daytona State win that game, they will take the conference. However, two teams, luckily, will make it this year from the conference to play in the playoffs. So they've got that going for them.
They do. You know, it just not the perfect situation where you're waiting for somebody else to have a result. But right now they got to take care of business here against ASA from Miami, a team they beat here before, and they do it. They did it with a pretty good margin. But once again, it's a matter of can you do it consistently, come out of the back, and just have almost a perfect game for 90 minutes.
A win by Broward tonight certainly complicates things. That keeps three teams alive, with the ASA the only team already eliminated, coming in 0-8 in conference play. And then you've got a situation where you got to go on the road. Eastern Florida, two games to make up in Broward to close the season, one there and one here.
And, of course, the tiebreaker would be head-to-head. If you have a three-way tie at the end, head-to-head, and then you go to goal average. So all kinds of different scenarios, and that's why the importance of when you have a chance like Eastern Florida had last Monday night here, you got to put them away, especially when you have the advantage of home field advantage.
And goal differential could play into that too. And as the teams get introduced to the crowd here on this beautiful October night, our anthem will be sung by Eastern Florida State College student Felina Chalk.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave Peru through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave?
done, Felina Chalk, with our star-spangled banner tonight. Let's get into the matchup here. Eddie is the player to watch. You have to say everybody's going to keep their eye on the goalkeeper, Jacobo Velez.
Yeah, Velez needs to have a good game, especially we talked about everything starts out of the back for them. They need to keep a shout-out for them, at least as long as they can, to stay in the game. So he knows he needs to come up with a big game to keep Miami in this contest.
This late in the season, you need some leadership, and that has been provided all season long by Craig McCall, the Scotsman.
Well, the captain out of the back, we've seen him. He's what I would call the unsung hero, always playing defense first, great tackles, he's great on the ball, and believe it or not, not a very a tall player, but he manages to, defy gravity, and he hangs in there. He does great in the air. And I like his distribution out of the back. He takes all the free kicks, set pieces. He does pretty well out of the back.
Yeah, Craig McCall will be the pivot there in the central midfield deep for Eastern Florida State College, who will have Bryce Notardonato in goal. And up top, Alex Alexis, Danilo Orsi, Dodomo. The one change from Monday night is that Alex McLennan in there for Siegel Knight, who picked up an injury in that game. ASA College, hey, it's a hodgepodge, a very technical team. Nicky Merritt is a player we remember from the last matchup. And there are the coaches. J.C. Gonzalez back stateside after being in Columbia earlier this season to deal with a family illness. Glad to have him back. And Oliver 12 Trees, certainly ready to see his guys get off on the front foot tonight, Eddie.
Yeah, you're right. The way Miami set up last time, it was totally different. But, they'll have 11. That's what we're going to go with. And then we'll sort out positions as the game goes on.
Tony Ballmer will be the referee. He'll sort things out. On the field, he'll be assisted by Darren Krause and Sean Michael Kemp. So fist bumps for everybody. Got a little wind blowing to our left, so blowing a little north. So perhaps a brisk wind could, on any balls in the air, could kind of be something to watch out for, especially for the goalkeepers.
As we see the women's supporting the men here, they've done their job. They're going into the tournament as the number one seed. They managed to finish their conference undefeated, just the way they wanted to go in. Congrats to them.
The skipper.
We like to say, el papá del señor Juan Carlos González, que nos ve desde Colombia, una recuperación grande y rápida, sobre todo de la enfermedad que tuvo, ya se recupera. A toda la familia González desde la capital de Colombia, Bogotá.
Bien.
Did you get all that?
I did.
We have Jet.
I'm sure you're talking about his native Colombian being back and helping his father out.
We're just wishing his dad a fast recovery. Of course, recovering from open heart surgery. And Juan Carlos González had to go as an emergency. And, of course, his assistant did a good job just keeping track of the team. And the team tried to do what they could. But we wish him a fast recovery back in Colombia.
His assistant, Jose Luis Sandoval, a former Mexican professional player, served on in the interim. But Jason González in his third season, second official season as a program. And former head coach at Johnson & Wales, the women's program. He's the associate head coach there. And then the head coach at Varela High School, one of powerhouse high school programs in Florida. Dade County Boys Coach of the Year. And now trying to right the ship here with ASA College and trying to turn them into a perennial contender in Region 8. So it will be the Silver Storm wearing purple, not silver. And it'll be Eastern Florida College in the Vancouver Whitecap-esque white jerseys attacking right to left to start things off. ASA College Miami will be Nicky Merritt along with, say, Sebastian Jardine doing the kickoff. Not sure who 19 was. We'll see as we move off. And we are underway here in Melbourne. Played back to Velez. Edwin McFarlane, the right fullback out of Honduras.
Rest assured that ASA Miami is going to play out of the back. Now that Juan Carlos González is back on the helm, he likes to play out of the back. He said, no matter what, we're going to play our style. We're not going to change things, not the season that he was hoping for, of course, with things happening personally and on the pitch as well. But he's going to remain doing the things he likes to do in the middle of the field, by keeping the ball and trying to have all the boys play the right way.
Salgado to McLennan, who launches the long ball forward, and the offside flag up on the far side on Danilo Orsidadomo. So really at the top of the formation, it's going to be Merritt and Daniel Schachtel. Schachtel had a goal off the bench against Eastern Florida back on the 1st of October.
Oh, and don't forget the change. So he's going to come up with a 4-2-3-1, meaning he's going to have two defensive center mids in the middle of the park right there. And then with having three in the middle, he can release one of those. Of course, the number 19 as a target forward, playing like a number nine. That's Sebastian Jaren.
Actually, Schachtel, there's two 19s on the roster, so we got that sorted out. So
no, that's what I meant, yeah.
Oh, okay, yeah. Sounds the same, Sebastian, Daniel.
You're absolutely right. Daniel Schachtel wearing 19 as well.
Wearing the orange boots. See him right now. And here along that right side, pushed ahead by Duque, who wore 20 in the last matchup and was very impressive. Here is Salgado. Johnny right along the touchline. Going to be a throw-in for ASA Miami. A couple of players out of the lineup for ASA, dealing with some injuries. Danny Rodriguez is a player wearing number nine. And Carlos Chacon, who had a good chance. An immediate, it's a goal on the other end. And a quick start for Danilo Orsidadomo, and it's 1-0.
Outstanding technical ability by Danilo Orsidadomo. Just when you thought he was going to take that shot to the far post with his left foot. No, I don't think so. He kept it 1-1. Great dribbling ability. And watch this angle right here. He gets the ball 1-1. There's a change of speed right now. He turns it on. Keeper comes out. Keeps the ball, and of course that should have been a left-footed tapping, but hey, when you score, I'm not gonna correct you on that. Great job, individual effort by Danilo, who was kind of quiet last game. I'm glad he woke up. Of course, one of the two acquisitions from the Chivas Academy out of Brayton. There's the other one.
We'll continue to put the pressure on here as Nate Dogg there, Nathaniel Grant there, pushing it out. And it'll be a corner kick as we look again.
Yeah, and here's another angle right here. Alexi gets the ball, and that's just kind of a deflection. And he takes him 1-on-1. When you have your defender just backpedaling right there, that's trouble. The keeper comes out, Jacobo Velez, just a little bit too late.
Big throw in. And it will go in the behind for a goal kick. It is 1-0 to the Titans here in the early going. Orsidadomo now team leading ninth goal of the season. And it happened that quick. So the Silver Storm playing defensive, and they had lightning strike against them.
Yeah, not the way Juan Carlos Gonzalez wanted to start this game. And once again, a deflection.
And Vela's able to corral it.
And that's why as a defender, you gotta get rid of the ball as quick as possible. Velez gets in trouble, just you gotta do it early. And of course, Eastern Florida's not gonna say no to a giveaway right there.
Now, under pressure and nearly forcing a turnover again. And getting out of trouble was Alec Hilburn. Hilburn is up, the Oklahoma City native. Get there, cut it out from Tony Ballmer, the referee.
Alec Hilburn gets kicked at the bottom, but there was no intention of making contact.
Free kick ASA here. It'll be Mosquera. Juan Mosquera. Boy, nice long ball across the field. Will keep the possession in favor of ASA as they trail here 1-0.
If you remember last game we did here against ASA, once they got their center mid working, they were able to get Eastern Florida a lot of trouble. They were playing the 1-2s and getting around the midfield, playing the through ball on the outside. So it's a matter of, you know, keeping the ball and trying to get the ball going forward. We know they have the ability and they have the players to do so. But you got to get your rhythm.
A throw here for Eastern Florida deep in their own end. Mauricio Rodriguez, their captain, settles under. Now that right winger, Duque, forcing it into the number 10 of Caleb Acosta.
Yeah, and he's the guy for ASA who's got to get the ball early right there. You see him, number 5 in the middle of your screen. When I spoke to Coach Juan Carlos Gonzalez, he told me, you know, number 5, Rodriguez right there, he's just the perfect college player. Great student, always early to practice, and just he's the epitome of a Division I athlete. He would love for him to go to the next level with a big-time program.
And this will be sent out off of ASA. Numbers will come back. This is Duque. Pong in the center of the park. McCall will drop it back to Fogg. Called off by the keeper, Bryce Nooner Donato out of Merritt Island.
The wind being a factor in this game, just kind of windy. So you want to put the ball down on the ground. Of course, we're never going to complain about the field
yes.
conditions here. Just a carpet, a putting green, if you will. So might as well put the ball down on the ground and let it roll, let it play.
Play ball. Pressure comes. Now Fogg on it. Plays it into space. Fogg will trot up. In front of him is Nathaniel Grant. Scored against this team in the last meeting here at the Titan Soccer Complex. Thinking about it again. And he will get a play on here as he went into the box, or went down outside of the box, going down inside the box. And
Alexis drawing the penalty kick for sure. There was contact in the box. Referee calls it. And it all starts out of the back. You talked about great run. Nate Grant, he scored last game. He does it again. He tries to go forward.
Yeah, and committing the foul, there was Mosquera. So a penalty situation here. McCall will get the call here, looking for his second goal of the season, and a 2-0 lead for Eastern Florida. He shoots and puts it right into the old onion bag. 1-0. Make it 2-0 now, his second goal of the season.
Clinical finish in that penalty kick by McCall, the captain. And once again, we talked about the ability of ASA to stay in the game. Watch this. That's how you take a penalty kick right there on the ground, midway, inside of your right foot to make it 2-0 for Eastern Florida.
8 minutes in, less than 10 minutes played, and it's a chance here for Eastern Florida to put up a crooked number on the scoreboard. Now Danilo Orsi-Didomo. He'll send across to that back post, and stretching out like Plastic Man was Jacobo Velez.
And you can start, you can see that now Eastern Florida, they're starting to get their game going. Good ball into the space for Danilo. He tries to return the favor to Alexis in the middle, and Velez comes out. Right time, wins the ball.
It's gonna be no problem. Notre Donato made a basket catch. McCall on it. McCall with the PK. Danilo Orsi-Didomo. Now into Alexis. Flag is up. He's fast, but a little too fast there.
Great job, Alec Hilburn, the defender for ASA, reading that play. He just stepped, took one step as Danilo was playing the ball, and he left Alexis offside.
It's a dangerous game to play, though, with him, though.
It is, because if you don't step the right time, he's gone. There's no way you're gonna track him down with that breakaway speed.
Orsi-Didomo Now it's J.J. Donnelly. A lot of attacking coming from this left side for Eastern Florida. Sends it across, headed out of play. Corner kick for the Titans.
And see, once again, now they're connecting. Danilo, J.J. Donnelly, he in-swings that ball looking for Alex Alexis to the far post. They get a corner kick here, and now they're playing the space. And you can tell J.C. Gonzalez is a little worried.
Nightmare start.
Not only, right, exactly, not only because of the score, but just you can see Eastern Florida starting to grow, starting to get their timing.
Certainly a long 48 hours since that last one, as McCall puts in the corner kick, headed out of trouble.
Which at the same time, a lot of the times it helps you though. If you can do a quick turnaround and win your next game, it helps.
You don't have to think about it, yeah. Orsi Dodomo's Velez comes out quickly. Had Alex Alexis breaking in. And our boy Owen Tworkowski stepping up there. There's Caleb Acosta, Pierre Barafranca. Barafranca testing it in front. Nicky Merritt. So you got France to the Netherlands there on that left side. And now intercepted by J.J. Donnelly, who's really the latter portion of this season has been more used a little more withdrawn into the midfield, not as a striker, but he takes opportunities to go at times.
And making those runs that you talk about, making, you know, choosing when to go, that's crucial. You want to pick your times, and when it's on, you go full on, and somebody will stay for you defensively, but you don't have to go every time.
Donnelly releases it after a masterful dribbling job by Alex Alexis. Coach 12 Trees, beginning of the season, likened Alexis to a Kevin Molino. Same type of player, the attacking forward for Orlando City.
I would say that's a pretty...
Dorsey Dodomo. Alexis gives it a go and didn't have enough real estate to bend that one back.
Yeah, he had time to hit that ball to the far post with his left foot, but I think Oliver 12 Trees right. They kind of have the same characteristics as far as they're the type of players who take you on. They have that speed, they have that change of pace as well, and they put you in trouble. One and one, they're going to dissect you, so you better be on your game.
You know, a good comparison there. Molino, the Trinidad and Tobago international, who began in USL for Orlando City. So they call him the original since he's been there since the beginning.
Yeah, you and I had a chance to do those games, and you know, he's been doing it USL, he's been doing it MLS. It's great to see that he hasn't changed his games. We saw him do them day in and day out.
Yep, last year tore an ACL and came back even stronger this year. Remember that first year there was a friendly against Newcastle United. He scored the game-winning goal.
Yeah, and if you remember the first year when they won it all, you know, he was just taking players on and just so hard to mark. Remember that great game he had against the Charleston Battery where he had a hat trick, and he was just literally unstoppable.
There's the run from ASA along the left side. Nicky Merritt, sophomore transfer from Abel Tasman College. On the near side, Edwin McFarlane. ASA trying to keep the ball here for at least a little bit, give the defensive side of the field a rest.
Well, and that's what they need to do. That's where they can find success. They're a very technical team. They're the type of team that likes to possess the ball, but right now they're too spread out, and if they can't find those four or five combination plays, it's going to be hard for them. They don't have the legs to run against an Eastern Florida who's, I think, a little bit more athletic and faster as well.
Carlos Redondo, Colombian freshman, get a little run out here, and coming off is McFarland. So see if he steps, it's one for one on that right side of defense.
Yeah, this is a good stop. Carlos Redondo had a good game last time. Colombian midfielder who likes to keep the ball as well. Good on the ball.
Kept alive, now intercepted. McLennan. And off to the races we go with Alex Alexis. Out of Miramar, Florida. Little step over once. Now tries to beat the man for speed. Takes it into the corner, waits for the help. Cuts it back, tries to get the inside position, and there a slight of build lets him down a little bit that time.
Yeah, he just took way too long to decide what to do. If you're going to take him on, you got to take him on early. If not, lay the ball off, spin off, and get the ball behind the defense playing one-on-one. So now everybody's sitting around waiting on you, and two defenders are going to close that space.
The left side, Eastern Florida, 2-0 lead. Now in really the nice ascendancy, a good position to be in. Now you can just kind of play a counter if you need to and just let the goals rack up.
Yeah, well, now you don't have that, you don't have that pressure of having to go forward. Now you go at will. If it's on, you go. If not, you're going to play it back, as we see here. Bring the ball all the way back to the goalkeeper and switch your point of attack. You see how deep Johnny Salgado is coming to get the ball.
Nate Grant will get the outside here and slid out and put out for a throw by Redondo.
Yeah, that's good. It's a good tackle by Redondo. And here it is, Alex Alexis, when he was going on a breakaway, took a little bit too long, one fake, step over again. And of course, Alec Kilburn, all he's got to do is stand him up, force him to the outside.
And don't dive in.
Don't dive in, because he's going to eat your lunch.
Meanwhile, free kick for Eastern Florida here. Marcy DeDomo will stretch it out.
Another good chance here for the captain, Craig McCall, to put the ball in play. Of course, you have the left foot of Nate Grant. Can go with an in-swinger, left-footed, right-footed. If you decide to go with McCall.
Watch out for J.J. Donnelly here.
Korkowski as well, making a run out of the back.
Play it to the line, Nate Grant, and that should yield a corner kick. It certainly does. And under 29 minutes to go, 2-0 lead, and set piece opportunity coming up for Eastern Florida.
I like the idea, wrong execution. That ball by McCall has got to be tighter. Play the ball too much into the space, giving the defender enough time to get there. I like the idea, though.
Play it
creativeness.
McCall will give it a go to the back post. Not a bad effort. It's in. Not sure who got the last touch, but it's a third goal of the night for Eastern Florida State College. Was it a strike off the foot of McLennan? Who gets credit? We'll have to take a look.
They might even give it to McCall. Jacobo Velez, the goalkeeper, actually got a hand on that. And look at this in-swinger to the far post. Goalkeeper touches that. It actually hits the back of Alex Alexis. The easiest goal he'll ever score.
Didn't even know it hit him.
He never even saw it. So off your back, I'm not sure if they're going to give it to McCall.
Sure, we'll have a better angle here upcoming, but we'll give it to Alexis for his third goal of the season. And McLennan will easily have an assist, if not more, on that one. Excuse me, McCall.
McCall, yeah.
McCall already with 8 assists coming in.
Great job on that, that little flick to the far post. In swings it, gets underneath the ball, and you see that's where the ball was dipping at the end.
It was a tough place, that corridor of indecision.
Absolutely. Jacobo Velez just reached out, got a glove on it, more like a nail, if that, and not able to completely get it out to make it 3. And now Eastern Florida is sitting pretty good as far as the score and the time as well. Now they can manage. So here's another angle here.
Service is in.
Oh,
yes.
It actually hit the defender as well. Number 2, Rodrigo Talledo. And
good
then he
work.
Hit. So it's a double assist. Talledo, Alexis. We'll give it to him for his third goal of the year. You're right. I think he's done enough. All those runs he makes, and he's earned it.
McCall's already got one, but man, putting that right on the right spot. And that keeper can't reach it, he's in trouble.
And
it's 3-0.
It's not like the goalkeeper was out of position or anything. You know,
just perfect
just
placement.
A great ball right there.
Tip your cap. Trying to go over the top here, and it will
reminds me of the
corner kick
of the goal from Messi, La Copa de Oro against the U.S., where he just put it right on the right spot.
Nothing
the goalkeeper could do. He wasn't even out of position, but he could only go one way, just the way he went in. Of course, that was his 53rd goal to beat Gabriel Batistuta for the Argentinian record for most goals in international competition.
Pierre Barrafranco serving it into the wind. Not really a bad effort in swinging. It will go out and yield the throw-in. Wind really picking up here as we get into the final 25 minutes and change of this first half. 3-0 the score. Goals for Morsi Dodomo, McCall on a PK, and now Alexis.
And of course, Jeff, it's important to remember that because of the goal average, Coach Twelvetree is not going to take it easy on ASA. He's going to try to score as many as he can because they're going to have to, of course, make up for the result on Monday.
It's the second tiebreaker after
head-to-head.
So you want to have the best goal differential in the conference. Right now they trail by, I believe, 4 goals. So can make up a bunch of it tonight. Now granted, they've got, including tonight, 3 games to play, where the other two are playing their last one. Jacobo Velez off his line to make sure nothing happens there.
Yeah, and you're playing them away, so you're not going to have the field advantage of this beautiful facility here.
Is not to concede, especially after that last
game
where you give up 4. Let's have a clean sheet and get the momentum back on our side.
That hurts, because he heard me the whole drive home. 4 goals.
Three spot and a half of a half and a quarter of a game so far.
And you and I talked about it. A lot of the times when you're trying to get that equalizer, which is what happened in the last game. They're trying to push the line. They're down 2-1. They're trying to get that 2-2, and you get caught in transition. Before you know it, you're giving up another 2, and now it's 4-1 instead of trying to get that 2-2.
A goal kick for Notre Donato.
And here comes the speedster.
Yaya Cisse, who has been playing hurt as of late, but give it a go here. And that will give Alexis a much needed rest. Got to charge up the battery. Our Donnelly is actually off. Fog, I'll make no mistake. Clear it. Comes near side.
And that's a good switch for ASA. That's what they need to do. Keep the ball, spread them side to side, then you can play that penetrating ball. But if not, you need to keep the ball. Even if you have to go negative, that's okay. As long as you start keeping, the ball 1, 2, 3, touch on the ball, possess the ball, make him come out.
Matthew Kautz had checked in as well, making his 6th appearance of the season, wearing number 24 for Eastern Florida. So it was Alexis and Donnelly that both came off moments ago. Love this as a coach because you can really get some guys some rest, get some other guys in.
Yeah, this is a good chance for you to mix it up a little bit and get some fresh legs.
Especially having this stretch of 4 games in 6 days. This is the 2nd of the 4. Game on Friday at Broward, and then again Sunday against Broward to close the season. One of those is a makeup game from rain-canceled or weather-canceled game.
And that's going to be a battle. Both teams know each other well. They play similar systems. They match up pretty well. So I expect those two games to be just definitely a battle.
Yeah. First meeting, it was a 1-0 win for Eastern Florida against Broward. That one put wide. We've seen ASA score from distance a couple of times when you least expect it.
That was a good idea by Daniel Schulte right there from outside, just looking for the far post. It's a good idea, though, because there's nobody marking him right on the 18, especially if you do it early enough where the goalkeeper, Bryce, stepping up.
Acosta into Barrafranca. Closed down by Twerkowski to the line, and a corner kick for the Silver Storm, who have certainly had to weather one here in the early going. Lennon. There, step for step. So set pieces always can get you right back into a game, especially with win that you got to judge. Curled in, flicked backwards over the top. Goal kick for
and
the Titans.
If not, ask University of South Florida, the women's. They gave up a goal Sunday in the 90th minute. 30 seconds left. Set piece, free kick into the box. Thank you very much. Cincinnati tied him up. Double overtime. So the importance of set pieces, and you and I talked about, we always talk about the importance of the first five and the last five, but even then, set pieces, there's no excuse. That's kind of like a mental mistake that you gotta be marked up all the time. Who do you have? Who are you marking?
Oh, nice ball from Cisse in. And gonna yield a corner kick, no, a goal kick. So Kotz couldn't quite yank it back. Key here, Eddie, too, right, is you got their foot on them. Now you got to step a little harder, right? You want to end this and give them no thought of a comeback.
Yeah, you got to make sure you put another one before the half and just don't let them think they have a chance to come back. It's so easy to let your foot off the gas and before you know it's 3-1 and they'll start climbing and don't even give them the first.
Well, Eastern Florida does not have the luxury taking part of a game off or lightening up. With the margin for error is very slim now.
Well, it's a great point you bring up because they can still win, but if they gave up a couple of goals tonight, that could be the difference between going through or not. So for them, not only, and that's why I said it during the intro, they almost have to play that perfect game where they got to score a certain amount of goals, but at the same time, you got to keep that shot out in the back. Big old donut, nothing defensively. No mistakes.
Again, Daytona State College and Broward playing against one another tonight down in Pembroke Pines. And another effort going awry. Orsi Didomo stretching himself out.
Yeah, Danilo and Jacobo Velez with that collision.
A knock of knees as we take a look.
And that's actually a great through ball right there. Cisse plays the ball for Kotz. Play the little flick. Danilo gets around.
Yikes.
As he was trying to make the goalkeeper right there.
Fogg escorts it out. Throw to the Titans here. We've got a 3-0 lead, under 20 to go in the first half. Coming in 8-4 overall, 4-2 this after the loss on Monday night. And two teams from the region will make the playoffs. Fogg will give it a go.
And ball never went in.
Not sure if the wind had a play. Yeah. The wind is blowing our way, so.
If you look at the linesman flag, how much is moving
yeah.
right behind him. I guess the ball did go in and came back out. You can tell it's windy. The whole women's team, they're wearing jackets and sweats. And you know the weather is definitely changing here in the Space Coast.
Nice time of year, if you ask me. Orsi Didomo. And we'll leave it a little too long for anything to come of that. Some time on the ball here for Mauricio Rodriguez, the captain. Lays it to the right side. Here is Redondo. Stepping to is Cisse. Tracking back, so is Johnny Salgado.
And see, look, the difference. I like the movement on and off the ball by Mauricio Rodriguez, the center man. And you can tell, so smart on the ball. Every time he touches the ball right there, number five, in the middle of the screen, he makes something happen. And that's what ASA needs to do. Keep the ball. You have to go through him right there. But look at his distribution. Does not lose the ball.
Bends it around. Stepping up is Toledo.
I thought he was going to let me down as soon as I said that he was going to give it away. But no. Keeps the ball.
Trying a little Red Hot Chili Peppers. Give it away, give it away, give it away now. That one's going to run out of real estate, and then we'll pull it back. Barra Franca into the box, escorted back the other way, and it leads to a throw in for ASA.
Much better though by the Miami side, keeping the ball, finding those gaps. They do have to be a lot more active, and for them, it's a matter of they got to put one in before the half to think that they'll have a chance.
Daniel Grant gonna run it down, and then we'll use his pace to get forward. Puts it out. Quick throw for McCall, and he'll leave it for Fogg. Up the line. Cisse can't get to it. Merritt in the middle of the park. Now Acosta.
Great step by
Orsi Domo. Nice turn.
Torkowski in the back. Stepped at the right time. Won the ball.
Salgado going to win it back. McCall makes the turn. Now drilled forward. And the race is on. Orsi Domo will not get there as Kautz let it fly from deep. Back here. See the wind ripping the jerseys right now. Merritt playing it back to Rodriguez. Hilburn, one of the center backs, out left. Barafranca one on one. Earns a throw in. Much better here for ASA the last 5-10 minutes.
Yeah, they finally getting their touches in. Once again, Rodriguez with the ball.
A little frustration shown by Duque.
And you can tell every time he gets the ball in the middle, he's motioned to his teammates, hey, get rid of the ball quicker, 1-2s, and you want to get that intensity up.
See Domo up the line. He's going to come back to Velez, playing it back wide. Mosquera. And it will be a foul against Eastern Florida. Juan Mosquera out of Cali, Colombia. Colegio Instituto Boliviano. Simon Bolivar, maybe, is the.
Yeah,
what that school is probably named after.
Yeah, Simon Bolivar.
Yeah. Very.
So Instituto Boliviano.
Say it better than me.
Well, it would be a shame if I didn't.
Say, what a better possession here as of late. Trying to force it in there, Rodriguez, and now releasing Orsi Domo quickly was McCall. He'll catch up now. Well, the Englishman.
Oh, great ball to the far post.
McCall save Jacobo Velez. Trying to get a foot in there, Salgado, nothing doing. Nicky Merritt. Marauding through, trying to play a ball through, and did not work to Acosta.
Yeah, but much better though. ASA finally getting their touches, finally getting some chances.
Grant on the pass from Cisse. Nathaniel Grant has the speed to get by, lays it back. Orsi Domo, and a big save by Velez to keep it out, or it would have been 4-0.
Oh, great save right there. Danilo with a wide open net. I think that might have been the defender, Pierre Barfacan, the Frenchman in the back, as he had it just open. I don't think he realized how open he was in the back.
Let's get a closer look here.
Yeah, I think it was Velez.
Got across in a hurry. Carlos Sanchez will check in for J.C. Gonzalez on this set-piece opportunity. Corner kick from the far side. McCall will set up with the right foot. In the air high. This has got a chance. Jumping in slow motion was Tworkowski. What do we have? Foul.
Barafranco was going to get the block on that one. And no, Grant's down. That's actually Fogg.
Louis Fogg, who likes to tackle. Not normally the guy getting hit
on that side.
And Oliver Twelvetree says, I can't deal with any more injuries here.
Yeah, I know. That's one of the things he's got to.
Juan Parada out for the rest of the season. Siegel Knight picked up a knock in the last game, hoping to get him back soon.
He's got to keep a clean sheet as far as the injuries.
Costa. Big challenge. Grant. Run continues from Sanchez. Throw in. Fogg walking gingerly back inside the 18.
Alex McClellan with that tackle. Jeez, did you see that from behind? I'm surprised he didn't draw the card on that one, even though he got the ball.
Another substitution. We'll check in for the Storm. Mario Ferro.
And watch this different angle by Alex McClellan on that tackle. Actually, that's all the way to the corner kick. And that deflection right there, that's an injury to Fogg. They were trying to clear the ball. He hit it with the outside of his right foot to his goalkeeper.
Mario Ferro sets up, the sophomore out of La Lima Cortez, Honduras. More of a forward last time we saw him play here.
And here's that tackle I was talking about by number 23. He gets back defensively, gets all ball. That's the way to tackle though, especially late in this first half.
The last thing you want is red card and going down a man, because that will give them all the chance in the world to get back in it.
Oh, absolutely.
Play it clean.
When I first saw the tackle, I thought it was going to be worse than that, but he actually got all ball. But you're right, though. You don't want to put your team in a bad spot because of one tackle. You want to make sure you go to that, that halftime with scoring your favor with a clean sheet.
Paul gets it away to Cisse, keeping on his right foot, switches to the left. Will work in across. And now ASA on the counter. Tworkowski will not let that one play through to Velas. Or to Ferro, excuse me.
Yeah, he's very isolated on top. If you're going to play with one forward, he's going to stay in the middle of the field. If you tend to go to one side, it's going to be really hard for the rest of the ASA team just to get you the ball. It's got to be almost a perfect ball.
Barafranca going to ground. Well, it's been 3-0 since the ...28 minutes to go, so been a while. ASA has kind of gotten their feet under them, and now play on, says referee Tony Ballmert.
Yeah, they kind of found that balance of defending right in the counter and then using that speed to try to break away on the counter and try to get something going. As we see the coach, Oliver Twelvetree, trying to just go into the halftime with that lead, 3-0, just not giving anything, and then he can just regroup and start the half again.
Oliver Twelvetree's his team scoring in the third, the eighth, and the 17th minute. Three goals in the first 20. ASA now playing with much more life and confidence.
Alec Hilburn showing that he also has some wheels in the back. Great defending.
Costa in the center. Rodriguez overruns it. Nice job by McLennan to recover.
Johnny Salgado's been kind of quiet in this first half.
The older McLennan can't keep it in. Matt. Two-time state semifinalist at McCarthy High School. This one's going to go to the line, picked up there by Sanchez. And now Salgado will be fouled from Rodriguez, and the card is already in the hand of Tony Baumert, so you know what's coming.
Yeah, the referee tell him, because you got him from behind, and Johnny Salgado cannot look at what's coming, so Mauricio Rodriguez with a yellow, and you can tell right here, it's a bad giveaway, but look, there's no way Johnny Salgado can take a look at what's coming, so that's always, you're going to draw the yellow if you're going to hit someone from behind like that. Even though you would say, well, that's not a huge contact. It's just the fact that you cannot protect yourself when somebody's coming from behind that is gonna draw that card.
Change for Eastern Florida. We'll see Adolfo Peraza come on, give Nathaniel Grant a little rest before half. 6 minutes to go in this first half, 3-0 the score. Try to have an update from that Daytona State Broward game a little later. Oh, okay. Hurt. Clock has stopped. Gotta wait.
Referee being very thorough, but I like when they talk to you and they explain to you why. Not the because I said so. Okay, that works. Not really.
It's a good daddy defense.
Yes.
Why? Because I said so. McCall. Service in. Tworkowski. Let it go through. Goal kick.
Tworkowski trying that cheeky little flick. Doesn't quite get enough of the ball. And see how fast Eastern Florida presses, win the ball again.
Mosquera with the giveaway to Salgado and immediately turned over on the offside.
Yeah, Caesar was in the corner. And if you're Caesar, you have to watch out that line right there. If you're the last player, you have to stay onside. Of course, the lineman all the way on the other side, but he's got the clear view. He's got the line, and that is his job. He's going to move with the defenders up and down with the last defender, knowing that he's got to call that offside trap at any given moment.
Gotts. Number 24 circling back, Matthew. And it goes into touch for a throw, quickly taken by the Silver Storm. And trailing by 3 goals here as we now are under 5 minutes to halftime here at the Titan Soccer Complex. So glad you're with us wherever you happen to be. Jeff Radcliffe, Eddie Rodriguez, and our entire WEFS TV crew. Getting to know you quite a bit here this week. Second of 4 broadcasts during the week as we're going to have some of the women's playoff games on Friday, the semifinals, and then Sunday the championship.
Yeah, and if things go well, we're going to be here for the next 2 weeks quite often. The boys' side and the girls' as well.
Tworkowski. Played for the legend Jerry McCabe. They're at Mel High. So did Nate Grant. Stars last year, Shari Saperi, Micah Smoke, also former Mel High alums. All played through Salgado. And it's saved off outside of the 6. Thought that was a goal for sure.
And that's definitely been a pipeline from the Bulldogs to Eastern Florida. We see Johnny Salgado down.
Shaking his head.
Some of those players you just mentioned, just great quality players.
Smoke playing in North Florida now, I believe.
Micah, he had a great year last year.
Cisse leaving it back inside the 18. Let's see if the Titans can tally another before the half. Here's Peraza putting it towards the back post. Headed into the air, offside flag was up again, that time on Matthew Cotts.
Great ball by Adolfo Peraza to the far post, trying to find the big man Matthew Cotts in the far post. And I'm not sure if he was offside before or after, meaning that he was on the offside position, then he tried to come out, and he was off again.
Hear that wind blow. See the flags.
One thing's for sure, though, he was all by himself. Well, we did say that Jacobo Velez, the goalkeeper from Miami, was going to be busy this half. And that pretty much has been the case.
Bradley Franklin has checked into the game, the sophomore out of Miramar, the transfer from Howard University. So, opportunity for Oliver to get some of these guys in. Got a big game coming up on Friday at Brevard.
Yeah, get him in and get some quality minutes. And if I'm not mistaken, that field is turf, isn't it? The Broward?
That's a good question. I know the field at Daytona is.
And here's that clearance out of the back from ASA. And that's that great cross right there.
Peraza.
That was a sitter right there. Might as well put a bow on it. Merry Christmas. Happy birthday.
Big throw all the way into the 18, chested down. And Fogg sends it back in, boy.
Wow.
Clearance was close.
Yeah, Velez not able to hold on to that ball. And here comes the counter.
On. Numbers back for Eastern Florida. They do the job to slow it up. Rodriguez on the ball at the halfway line, under a minute to go, first half, 3-0. Now here's where Eastern Florida last Monday gave up that goal with a minute to go in that half. And you talked to Oliver Twelvetrees, that's where the game turned.
And this is where you have to be tactically disciplined. The last minute of the game, stay home. You don't have to go forward if it's not on, unless you're a Cisse on your bike right now. And everybody else, just stay home and play defense.
Oh, plays a beautiful ball through Orsi Didomo. It was read well by Velez. And now under the final half minute. Silver Storm in no hurry to advance the ball with 10 seconds to go.
Yeah, this is where if you're Miami, you wanna rush the possession and get there to a position where you can get either a corner or just a shot from outside the box.
Vogg had that covered. Three goals in the first 20 minutes. Give the Titans a 3-0 lead. Holding on against the Silver Storm. We'll be right back on WEFS's coverage of Titan Soccer.
Eastern Florida State College women's soccer team battles in the Region 8 tournament semifinals live Friday at 5 on WEFS. Recently, the Eastern Florida State College women's soccer team held its 2016 media day. Head coach Jeff Carr looks to return to the national tournament with what he feels may be his best team yet.
Well, I think we have a very athletic team, a very dynamic team. We have a lot more depth this year than we did last year. We have, I would say, 16 to 18 players that can contribute. Different countries represented, different styles of play, but we're still a possession-oriented team with a lot of speed this year. As I've always said, speed kills. And we have a lot of talent. You know, returning Paula, Jay, and Bunny is really exciting, and then the new players we have coming in as well.
Well, we have a pretty good team this year. We have three return players, so we have a brand new team, and we are trying to put it all together and see how it works and getting better every day and see if we get like all the team shape and all the players together and do team bonding because that helps to build the team up, and hopefully we can make it to the national championship.
Well, I think the craziest part to me is that all of us come from different parts of the world and we all know how to play soccer the right way, but then when you put us all together randomly, it's like, what is everybody doing? But our team this year, it's crazy how much we've come together and how much team chemistry we have. Coach Teresa was just saying last night after the game that the team chemistry and with pressing and our shape and talking and stuff is just crazy, and she's never had another team that's blended together so well on the field like that. Of course, like, different parts of the world play different ways. Like Laura from Spain, she's used to pass, not balls in behind. So everybody has to adjust to the different ways, but it'll get there, I think.
My expectations for this team is to first and foremost make it to the national championship, but in doing so, we have to do what is required. We have to listen to the coach and execute on the given day what we're supposed to do. So that's first and foremost my expectations, and then we can move from there.
So check the website for game times and come out and support your Titan soccer team on their quest for another conference championship and appearance in the national tournament.
You should come out because we have a lot of players from different countries who play in different ways than people have seen before, and we're going to score a lot of goals. We're a really attacking-oriented team. You might see something you've never seen before.
This is where we're building the future. This is where we meet the challenge, where leaders emerge and careers take flight. This is where you discover new opportunities. Choose to stand where excellence lives, where Titans rise. Eastern Florida State College.
My wife is currently in the Air Force, so I decided to be a stay-at-home father.
I'm a retiree and a full-time student.
I did online classes because I was traveling and it was easy to take the classes with me.
I am graduating today with my bachelor's in business administration.
If it wasn't for the online classes, I would not be standing here today.
There shouldn't be any procrastination. Just get out there and go do it.
Join local sportscaster Eric Kohler as he hosts Eastern Florida State College coaches and student athletes for a closer look inside Titan sports. Produced in partnership with Florida Today, the weekly in-depth program covers the 11 Titans men's and women's sports teams through game footage and coaches' analysis. Get closer to the action at a special time this Thursday night, 8:30, here on WEFS.
We are back at the Titan Soccer Complex in Melbourne. Sun going down behind us as Eastern Florida bossing a game against ASA College of Miami, 3-0 the score. Eddie Rodriguez, this is just what the doctor ordered after a very tough defeat on Monday. Come out and get off to a quick start scoring in the first couple of minutes.
Absolutely. That's the type of start they needed to have. Just from the beginning, just get off the blocks, start the right way, score up a couple of goals, dictate the tempo of the game, don't give anything up, and that's exactly what they've done. They've been able to maintain not only the score, but just the possession. They get to go at will, and of course, they have those great breakaways. So right now, they're sitting in a good spot. Now, you got to take it per half. The second half, the game starts again. Make sure you got to take care of the ball the first 5-10 minutes. Put them away, get a couple of goals, and then you can coast till the end of the game.
Well, it started before we could really settle into this one, as there was a chance down this left flank. Danilo Orsi de Domo, easy as you can make it right here. One of the easiest goals he's scored, now on 9 for the season. Remember, he started the season as a reserve player coming off the bench. But then 5 minutes later, foul outside the box, then inside the box. And that would be a penalty kick. And Craig McCall.
Yeah, great taken to the far post. And then McCall, once again, he flicks the ball to the far post. Jacobo Velez doesn't quite get enough.
The play
back. Great touch right here. Yeah, great one touch with Danilo. He looks far post, gets under the ball, and he gets a little bit of help from the post, the defender as well. And then, of course, give credit to Alex Alexis, who scores the easiest goal he'll ever score. He didn't even know he scored.
No, off the shoulder, off the back, not sure. And they kept coming. Grant here getting a cross into McCall. Or is that Orsi Didomo? Yeah, it was Orsi Didomo.
Yeah, that was Barrafranca in the back. The Frenchman clearing that on the line.
And with a service here from Peraza. This was late in the half. And header was a little too high and off target. But that yields a 3-0 lead. All those goals coming in the first 20 minutes of the match. Conga cam time here at the Titan Soccer Complex. Is to have a pretty decent crowd on hand to watch this all-important game. If you're Eastern Florida, now Eddie, you've got everything in control. How do you want to come out and maybe score a couple and put it to bed, put it dead to rights?
Yeah, you do. It is critical because if not, you don't want to come back and sit. There's plenty of time for ASA to come back and put one in and really think we have a chance to come back in this game. So if you're Eastern Florida, come back in, put one or two away, keep the ball, keep possession, and then once again, you can control the tempo of the second half. You can also, control when you go forward, and you can afford to sit back a little bit more.
Well, our next broadcast going to come your way on Friday is the women's soccer team going to take on Polk State. That's the 1-4 matchup in the Region 8 playoffs. 5:00 kickoff in that one, and should Eastern Florida get by, and of course they've beaten Polk State twice already this season convincingly, they will play the winner of Broward versus Daytona State College on Sunday. That game coming your way, 8:00. That will be a web-only broadcast. We will have it covered for you right from start to finish, so get to check out and scout the opponent, if you will, on that one. Is the season coming down to the nitty-gritty on both sides for the Eastern Florida State College men and women. Brisk night, beautiful night for soccer. As we look around the campus here, these are the games where you can run all night, right?
All night. You talk about perfect conditions. Here it is, probably 65, 70, and you feel like you're not even moving. It's just so cool that you can literally just run all night.
And that's what Eastern Florida is going to be tasked to do, is Coach Oliver Twelvetrees getting a number of reserves in there in that first half. Always an advantageous position, but they need to close it out. Silverstorm trail 3-0. Take a quick break. Come back with the second half on WEFS.
Eastern Florida State College. This is where you discover new opportunities, where you pursue your dreams, and careers take flight. Apply now for new bachelor and associate degree programs in business, healthcare, computer technology, and other growing fields. Eastern Florida, where Titans rise. Apply today.
Eastern Florida State College women's soccer team battles in the Region 8 tournament semifinals live Friday at 5 on WEFS. Recently, the Eastern Florida State College men's soccer team held its 2016 media day. Head coach Oliver Twelvetrees feels confident about his team as they try to return to the national tournament.
It's really probably the first time that I have a true group of sophomores that have the experience and the leadership and the right attitudes moving forward that it has really helped in the preseason so far. I've got a number of really fantastic leaders that are really helping me and my coaching staff mold the younger players, understand what is expected of them and what the demands are. And if they're not getting it done, then they're helping me you know, make sure the players understand what's to be expected of them.
Yeah, I mean, the goal is definitely to get to that finals, but a lot of us who are in the squad from last year remember that feeling of losing, and no one enjoyed it, so we don't plan to let that happen again. So we're pushing this year more to get fit and put ourselves in the best position to win the games we play.
I think our team this year is like pretty good. We have quality players from all the way from around the world, so the connection, the past couple games, it was pretty good. So
when you go to watch a sporting event, you want to be entertained, you want to feel what the players are feeling, and I think we'll do well at that, getting the crowd involved and make you want to come out not just once or twice, make you come out to every home game and try and get a big team spirit and school spirit, which I think is key.
Because if you're looking for excitement, see, going forward we've got some real, real dangerous players, like players who will get you off your seat. That's the best thing about us, to be fair. And yeah, if you want to see goals, excitement, that's why you should come to watch us.
So check the website for game times and come out and support your Titans soccer team on their quest for another conference championship and appearance in the national tournament.
We have a very exciting team. You're going to see players that are going to go on and be professional soccer players. And there's no doubt about it. You know, we have a tradition here of sending players onto top Division I programs and into pro soccer. And this team is going to have more players playing in the pros in the future than any other team I've had in the past. We have a number of players that are going to be at that level. So you're going to see future pros. You're going to see very, very exciting football being played, and some good stuff.
This is where we're building the future. This is where we meet the challenge, where leaders emerge and careers take flight. This is where you discover new opportunities. Choose to stand where excellence lives, where Titans rise. Eastern Florida State College.
My wife is currently in the Air Force, so I decided to be a stay-at-home father.
I'm a retiree and a full-time student.
I did online classes because I was traveling and it was easy to take the classes with me.
I am graduating today with my bachelor's in business administration.
If it wasn't for the online classes, I would not be standing here today.
There shouldn't be any procrastination. Just get out there and go do it.
In Melbourne, ready for second half action. We've kicked off. Eastern Florida leading ASA College Miami by a count of 3-0. Jeff Radcliffe, Andy Rodriguez back to call. Is Eastern Florida attacking left to right to see what kind of energy they come out with here in the second half?
Well, that is crucial. We talked about what they need to do for the second half, and I think matching the tempo and intensity of the first 10 minutes, the first 20, if you will, the way they came out, it's important for them because they were up 2-0 the first 10, so it is important for them to come back and do it. We see Alexis.
Really got an extended rest there, the latter stages of that first half. Save those legs for Friday. Again, this is the second of four games in a six-day span for Eastern Florida.
And of course, this is when.
Ay, ay, ay. And that will be a free kick at the minimum.
Yeah, Danilo get taken down there. Trying to sell the foul, holding his face.
And the referee, Tony Ballmer, will let it go for now.
Here's a different angle. The ball gets played into the space. Danilo brings it down. Just a little bit of contact with his left arm, left hand. Good chance once again for McCall. He's got that in swinger.
He's had some great service tonight so far. Plays it Salgado, trying to make the turn at the corner of the 18. McCall leaves it right to Jacobo Velez. Couldn't bend it back enough. If you're ASA, got 43 minutes now to get three here to get a result and not concede another at the same time, which is going to be the hard part.
That's the hard part right there. As we see that number 10, Caleb Acosta getting taken down in the middle. Quick reset. Rodriguez on the ball.
All fairness, though, Silver Storm really the last 25 minutes of that half after the third goal went in. Say they played Eastern Florida really straight up, even game. Alexis getting in behind. Waiting for the support. He outruns his support sometimes. Header to the back post. And to the line it goes. And it's going to be a corner kick for Eastern Florida.
But no, you're right, though. They did the same thing last time they were here. ASA, once they start knocking the ball around, they're able to keep possession of the ball and create some chances as well. And for them, it's about coming out, intensity, tempo, possession of the ball. So for them, if they want to have a chance to get back in this match, they got to do it in the first 10.
McCall. Last corner. Oh, that one to the line. Always have to hold your breath when Alex Alexis is near the ball. Oh,
yeah, he had a chance
through the right side here.
Had a chance to hit the ball with his left foot. And here's a double collision here. The first one.
Stopping the clock with the injury.
And it all started from the corner kick by McCall. Alex not able to make contact.
Yeah, it was off of Ellis.
And it's after that that the collision occurred right next to the bench from Eastern Florida.
Trainers are on the scene. Clock stopped, 41:34 mark. And it was Nicky Merritt, slow to get up, the Dutchman. And there's the Welshman, Oliver 12 Trees, now in his fourth season.
Oh, I thought he was Irish. No?
From Swansea. We look back at what happened there with Nicky Merritt.
Yeah, both players chasing the same ball. And that's Fogg right there. Actually, Nate Grant.
Yeah. Got an armful of Nathaniel Grant. A free kick ASA. Just inside the halfway line as you take a look at JC Gonzalez. Columbia native. Time high school coach here in Florida. The right side coming away with it. ASA all served into the area, giving chase is Adriel Bernal, the Cuban.
Yeah, Bernal was one of those players that came off the bench last game, and he was definitely an impact player with that speed. Not a huge player, but he's got that breakaway speed, and he's pretty good technically. So Juan Carlos Gonzalez uses him kind of a decoy where he can make some runs. We see him here on the ball.
Bernal from Hialeah Gardens. So his hometown team, as that's where the Silver Storm play their home games.
Now
will be a free kick here.
Yeah, Juan Carlos Gonzalez, before the game, he said, I want to make sure that we create a team that the home talent from around Hialeah and all the Miami cities can actually be proud of and, you know, played. Talking about all the different backgrounds and all
sure.
the different ethnicities, especially Latin American players in the Miami area, and what a great quality they have.
Direct kick is wide of the target. It'll yield a goal kick now for Bryce Notardonato. Has been an unbelievable shot stopper at times this year. It's a freshman with some room to fill out, of course. Yeah, Joseph Gucci playing the second half here with a 3-0 lead instead. So the Lithia native and for the Merritt Island native here in the second half. Good catch there by our producer Brian Foster.
Yeah, I know this is a good chance for, you know, give the backup goalie a good amount of time on the field, especially as you get ready towards the tournament and you're getting ready to go further into the playoffs. You never know when you're going to need your backup goalie.
This will be his third appearance. 1.33 goals against average coming in. And it'll be Eastern Florida ball on the throw here. Just over 6 minutes into the second half, as you see Oliver 12 threes. His assistants Nick Robinson and Nicholas Nazon. Coming back to get it. McLennan booted forward. Nakabo Velez. Looked like this game was gonna be in the shades of 5 and 6-0 at one point. It's been pretty even since the 3-0 lead.
Yeah, Eastern Florida sitting back a little bit, except for that one when Johnny Salgado was putting pressure on the goalkeeper. But it's almost like they're content just sitting and waiting for ASA to bring the ball to them. And, you know, two ways to approach that. Yeah, you don't have to go chase the game. However, I think you do have to score a goal here in the second half just to, you know, put things away.
Gucci. Toledo, the header, left back. Merritt is back in. Rodriguez sprays it wide. Stop start and intercepted on the left side by Grant. Off to the races. Raced to the near side now. Trying to save it in. Orsidodomo, no. Stretching it out.
Yeah, Grant took a little bit too long to play that through ball. He was actually waiting for Danilo to make a run. Danilo was kind of standing by the time he played the ball. Not the ball he wanted. You want to play him into the space. And of course, by the time he got the ball to the outside, he wasn't able to keep the ball in bounds.
Kleinen with the throw in. Here is Johnny Salgado of Bradenton, Florida, Southeast High School. His freshman season.
Yeah, another one of the two players from the Chivas Academy, and they're doing great things down at the Academy for Chivas. They have a great team in that U19 category, playing in those international tournaments. I know they played Montverde, that academy.
Yes.
That powerhouse in Orlando
you and I have talked
about. And they actually only lost by one. I think it was 3-2, so kudos to the Chivas coaching staff and what they're trying to do. They go against some really tough competition, and
sure,
that's why they're producing great players like Johnny Salgado and, of course, Danilo, who's just on a tear this year for Eastern Florida.
Montverde Academy's high school team, I believe, four-time national champs under head coach Mike Potempa. And his counterpart on the girls' side, Robbie Aristodemo, will be sitting right here on Sunday for that Region 8 championship game, hoping to watch his former player, Nathalie Da Silva, of Eastern Florida State College play in that final. A Montverde graduate. So the girls program, they're catching up to the boys quickly.
Oh yeah, they definitely are doing things the right way. And they're not only recruiting the right type of player, student athlete, but they train like a pro team. Just
yeah, granted, it's not a typical high school team. It is a boarding school with international recruits. So it's a little bit of a different situation, as you already alluded to.
But this is what I like about them. They're doing things the right way. They're teaching the kids how to play the game. It's not like they're just going, they're getting these great athletes, international backgrounds, and they continue their growth, not only off and on the classroom, but they're producing some great players, you know. And I like that formation. You're creating that atmosphere that you're going to have the expectation as well. I know I got a chance to do their game at Disney against AS Roma, and I tell you what, man, that was a heck of a game.
You'll be Oh, here's a chance for Adomo again. He just sneaks into the play.
So deceitful. He doesn't look like he's a fast player, but he's got that change of speed. As we saw in the first goal tonight, he changed that speed. Before you know it, he's behind you, and he's got great technical abilities. You know, he's got that smell for the goal. Typical forward.
Salgado turns. Call, playing it back to Joseph Gucci. You'll be headed out doing some games out west, Eddie, too, this weekend.
That's a dangerous ball and that giveaway in the back. You know, and if you're going to lose the ball in transition, you cannot give it in the middle. Clear the ball, go out, but playing that through ball, you got lucky there because Rodriguez was a little bit too late. Do not want to give the ball. And you know, I talked about, you do not want to give one right now. If you look at the clock, you know, they're not past that time where it's dangerous. You need to keep adding points and, you know, of course, goals. They're going to turn into points.
Oh, maybe Alexis can do something about it. The speed gets him behind off his line. Velez shot, score! Alex Alexis has a brace in this one. It is 4-0.
And that's exactly what speed does for you. Alex Alexis on the breakaway. Just as I was talking about it, Eastern Florida needed to make that score. What about this ball by Danilo Orsi-Dodamo putting through Alex. Velas comes out. Not a chance with that speed. And making in two for his personal account, four for Eastern Florida. As we see head coach Oliver Tweltree with another change. But now you can tell it's a little bit easier. Now you can breathe. Now you can say, you know what, let's keep the ball. We don't have to go forward now. That's the one what they needed.
Now ASA will have to take more chances and leave some space in behind to try to get back into this one, and it could yield a bigger score line. We will see. So, Alexis.
That's exactly how the game got away from Eastern Florida on Monday night. They try to push the lines as late in the game, trying to get that 2-1. It was a score at the time. They were trying to get that 2-2, and by doing so, they left themselves open in the back, and of course, before you know it, they have given up two unanswered goals.
Alexis came into this game with just two goals scored this year. I mean, he's doubled his production. It's hard to believe.
It is.
But he's been a guy who's really helped out everybody else and really has not been rewarded on the goal list. But tonight,
no, you're right.
See what he does.
It is amazing that he's only scored two goals because he does so much. So we see this.
He draws so much attention, and it opens up for everybody else. Take another look. It's just the turn and burn right here.
And this is a great turn by Danilo. He holds on to the ball. Great turn. Knows that he's got to play the ball to Alex in the front. And look at that speed. He gets around. And you can tell Jacobo Velez was just way too late. Either you come out, he got caught up in no man's land. Either you come out, top of the 18, or you're just going to stay home and wait for the defenders to close that. But when you're dealing with so much speed that Alex has, it's so hard to, you know, to judge. Whether you come out, do you stay? You got to take your chances.
Four nothing. So Eastern Florida has put up a four spot now in all three meetings this year against ASA. And we'll hold up play here as Caleb Acosta, the Argentine, out of Slam Academy down in South Florida. The sophomore puts it back into play.
Slam Academy, another high school we got a chance to call during the high school state finals.
Acosta comes back to Toledo, dealt with there by Tworkowski. Now you can really sit back.
So we were just saying it's amazing that Alex only has four goals total in the season. Well, he had two prior to this game tonight. And if you look at his counterpart in the women's, Darren Davis, with, you know, placing speed as well, she's, I think, up to 14, 15 goals. Speaking of
corner
course,
kick.
And how much speed does for you.
As Adolfo Peraza plays the corner short into Alexis. Another ball served in! It's a hat trick for Alex Alexis. My goodness.
Well, now he heard us, and now he's on a tear. Great. Great ball. He gets on top of the 18 right there. Right there. Adolfo Peraza calls him for that. Plays the little ball. Alex, nobody around him. Take a touch. Far post.
Bazinga.
That's in-swing it to the far post. That's what you want to do when you have all that time and all that space. Turns that into a hat trick.
Right on the hour mark. It's 5-0 with a half hour to go.
And now you are really in command with five. As if you were in a three, of course, you hit that four early in the second half. And now at five, you absolutely know that you don't have a chance. I mean, it's literally impossible to come back from five. And it just, I say impossible because of the time, of course. Yeah, if it was a new game, but in 30 minutes, and just the fact that you hadn't had a clear shot in the last 15.
I can tell you right now, you know, Oliver 12 Trees wants the clean sheet. He wants this stuff.
Oh, for sure. It is so important to keep that. No mistakes. We talked about playing that perfect game in the back. Just get that big fat donut.
Gucci high into the air. And some of the reserves back on. Matthew Kotz. Along the back. There's Toledo.
Great information from our producer. We were four goals behind Daytona, so this five right now puts us at a plus one.
Depending on the result tonight.
Correct. Depending on what they do, of course, on the other side. So every single one of these goals from now on counts. But the most important one is the one that you do not give up. So you cannot afford to give up any, if possible.
Making no mistake, Gucci. Way to the halfway line, picked up by Acosta. As ASA trying to save face in this last half hour. And this is their last game of the season. Currently 1-10 and cruising towards 0-9 in conference play. But not a team that to be taken lightly. They've been in a number of games this year and really force you to work.
It is really crazy to see the talent they have, and all of a sudden you hear about they had a game 3-1, all of a sudden they give it up at the end. But you're right, a very talented team. They just got to figure out a way to play for 90 minutes, and that's one of the things that their coach, Juan Carlos Gonzalez, talked about. Yeah, and of course, knowing that he had to go to Colombia once again, a fast recovery para su papá, Edilberto Gonzalez. Que tenga una recuperación rápida desde Bogotá, Colombia. Hopefully he's doing better in his recovery. As we see the referee checking with his linesman. I'm not sure if it was a handball or.
What this is about. Well, the linesman saw something.
Yeah, I'm not sure if he's saying that the goalkeeper came out with the ball when he had it under his hand or the contact.
Well, has a word there with Daniel Schachtel. He did score quite a goal against Eastern Florida in the first meeting back on the 1st of October. Gucci, it's a big leg into it.
Yeah, he had that bomb. Right, as I was about to call the wrong 19.
I'm sorry, I did the same thing, top of the broadcast. 219, Sebastian Jarin, or Harin. Gucci, take his time on the release here. Joseph, a long ball. Forrest Kotz. Throw for Eastern Florida. Marcy Dodomo will leave it for McLennan. Yeah.
You know, our producer had a great point when he asked me, well, is it, do you think it's a good idea that Eastern Florida is trying to keep that shutout, and all of a sudden you switch the goalkeepers at half? And of course, there's two ways to look at that. Yes, it's a little bit dangerous, but because ASA, they really haven't had that many clear chances. Defense is doing a good job for Eastern Florida.
Morrissey Dodomo hanging in the six and put into the back of the net. Yaya Cisse, fourth goal of the season, and it is a rout now, 6-0.
Cisse to make it four on his personal account. And once again, Danilo doing what he does best. Alex with a little flick. Danilo, right-footed shot, and I think Vela's got a hand on that. That's why it hit the post rather than going the back of the net. And now there's truly a wide-open game for Eastern Florida.
64 minutes, and you hear some of the lads saying, let's get more, come on.
Well, you need more, because if you think, you might only be a plus one or plus two right now.
Yeah, if there's a three-way tie, which can happen here tonight if Broward gets a win. And
so now if Broward gets a win by two, you know, and that's what we need to think about. Now you get into the numerical equation. So, you know, of course, a plus one, plus two, depending on.
Of course, Eastern Florida has to win the games in Broward, too, at the
correct
same time.
Yeah, you still have to go down and win those games.
Well, the one in Broward on Friday and then the one back here Sunday on sophomore night. Behind trucking.
But at least by doing so, you give your team a chance, you know?
Oh, we'll be fouled there. And again, he's going to have a little chat with Barafranca.
Yeah, Barafranca, Pierre Barafranca, just a little bit too eager to defend that ball.
See, Dodomo taking it all the way in, skying for it was Velez.
Sees it jump 5 minutes early.
He got one goal as we take a look right here.
And once again, a long throw. Now you don't have JJ Donnelly, but once again, Danilo finds it and he takes a right footed shot. And I think Velez just deflected that ball just enough so the ball didn't go in and hit the bar.
Clean up on aisle 11.
Cisse was not going to get denied.
Continuing to have some energy on the defensive side there as Alexis dropping all the way back. Ball put in and got a corner kick. And you can see the intensity right now on the lads from Eastern Florida.
Well, you can tell right there he was not happy about getting that ball. He just cleared the ball, get the ball out. That was Lewis Fogg yelling at Alex. Say, you know what?
If you're going to come back here to defend, you got to do it right, my man.
None of that little cheeky back, you know, back heel flicks inside the 18. You want to clear that. Get it out once again. And so you can tell that the players know the importance of not giving up a goal right now. Because literally that 6-0 game, you turn into a 6-1, 6-2, and it might not be enough. And they know that. They're well aware of that. Oliver Tweltree has done a great job just, you know, telling the boys, look, this is where we are because of the game we gave up on Monday night. We put ourselves in a tough situation. Now we get ourselves out of it.
Got to keep digging. Fog, marauding.
And
whatever was said after that last game or at halftime as well was paying off.
Yeah, you see the intensity even with 23 minutes left in this half, in this game. And you know what, just that's what it comes down, tactical discipline. You gotta stay disciplined for 90 plus minutes and you gotta get the job done. The task at hand. Nicky Merritt getting up slowly.
Not going to be a good bus trip back to Miami at this rate, the season finale. But it's a program that that's being built slowly. They've had some games where they were within a goal against Daytona State.
Yeah, Coach Gonzalez talked about their transition. Last year, they were a school first-year program, no scholarships. This year, they do get some help, mostly academic. So they're going through the pains of growing a program, and now he knows, look, we got to get better to play full games, 90 minutes. We're playing 50, 60-minute games. There's a couple of games where we had him in the bag, and we let him get away, and that's a problem for a program.
Twarkowski leaning on the corner flag there, putting it in a couple of inches more into the ground, I'm sure. Twarkowski, big throw down the line. Acosta on the ball. Good team defense, turns it over. Cisse composed. Orsita Domo trying to play it through, comes away. Crosses halfway and continues the run. And now Alexis breaking through and will lay it back. And nobody there to put it home. But another bang bang play for Eastern Florida.
Between those two, watch. Danilo figures out a way to go through three, four players just when you thought he was going to lose the ball. Gets it again, keeps going. Right when he's going to lose the ball, gets it again, keeps going. And right when he loses the ball, Alex just turns on the Jets to go one-on-one with the goalkeeper. Good job by Velas.
Just to slow it down. Boy, Halloween just a few nights away. It's been a horror story for poor Velas. Number two is approaching.
Scary. We did say early in this game that he was going to have his hands full.
Alex.
He was going to see plenty of action. This is when, as a goalkeeper, you get to rack up the stats. You might finish with something like 20 saves in this game. Yeah, you might give up a few goals.
Yeah.
More than few, but of course, this is when your goal average as a goalkeeper, it also goes down.
He stopped his fair share, too. Barafranca in traffic. Only ball available, the negative one back to Rodriguez. Mauricio leaves it square.
Yeah, Barrafranca's been active too. You see him in the back making runs.
Mauricio forward, intercepted. Gets as far as halfway. Pulled back by Mosquera. Nicky. Little Nicky. From the deep south.
That was a great ball by Nicky into the space. To that number 17 out wide, Carlos Sanchez. Another native from the Miami area. So many good players around there.
Final 20 minutes. 6-0 score line. A hat trick from Alex Alexis, the story here. Still in there. And can he get a four? That one, Jacobo Velas came out to meet him.
Great job by Velas, because that would have been the fourth, you're right. And that's the right timing of when do you come out.
And what rate do you start taking guys like Alexis out of there, or Orsi Dodomo out of there? And if you're Coach 12 Trees, I guess one of the problems you have is you only have so many healthy bodies.
No, right. Yeah, you probably leave him with about, I would take him off with about 10, because then you don't want to risk an injury, of course. And I said 10 Ooh. Because you want to maximize the production. If you can get another two, that'll be great. And you're running in that fine line. Yeah, get some goals in, but also keep the healthy bodies, no injuries.
Cisse. Moving through, not happy with letting that one go. And Mosquera intercepts. Like the idea, just couldn't execute.
Yeah, Matthew Kotz open on the right, tried to play the through ball. Not enough.
In the end, here's a ball across. Too far for Nicky Merritt. Circle back. Defense is there, laying it through, and Barrafranca zigged when he should have zagged.
Here's another look. Cisse on the ball, play the ball into the space. And watch that speed right there. It's almost like they're standing still. This is Jacobo Velas. Gets out at the right time and gets a save. Alexis, though, with totally different gear. he turns that on, man, and you're in trouble.
Bradley Franklin back in there for the Titans. So, boy, Alexis again to Cisse, top of the box, gets through. Can he get a foot on it? He cannot. Jacobo Vela is just able to stop it. Cisse with his fourth goal of the season in the 64th minute. Going to be wide open, I feel, last 17 here.
Yeah, now the game's so stretched out. And here's another look between Cisse, Alex. He gets the ball from Alex on the outside. The ball just trickles away from him. That would have been his fifth if he was able to control the ball.
Now Eastern Florida padding the stats tonight. Doubt about that. Danilo Orsi Dodomo started the party in the third minute. Escorted the ball into the net from close range. Twarkowski heads it back, and now Gucci. A little contact there along with Mario Ferro. Twarkowski had hit it backwards. Don't want to switch off at this point.
You do not want to give up anything this late in the game. Just keep going forward, take your chances.
McLennan, Franklin. Build up will continue on the left side for Pierre Barrafranca. Will cut in, not many options. Does find Schachtel. Switch. Far side, Peraza won it in the air. Alexis got a touch, now we'll run through. That's one way to stop him, give him a shove to the ground. It'll be a free kick on the push from Carlos Sanchez.
Yeah, Carlos Sanchez with a foul, and that's actually a good professional foul because he was gone after that. Early quick restart.
This is caught, taken down in the box. No call, not gonna get that up 6-0.
Yeah, no. And actually, I think he hit the ground as he was trying to make contact with the ball. And now the game's completely open, side to side. It's
end-to-end.
More of a tennis match.
Well, Jerry Thor will enjoy that for sure. He's watching the tennis coach here at Eastern Florida, starting up the men's program this year. Coached the women to new heights last year. Big tackle there made by Mosquera.
You got to be 15. Careful with that. Cisse, he's been a little shaky from the last game. You don't want to go into those tackles. As we see Danilo fighting for the ball, another player you don't want to see injure.
Acosta. Gucci slows it up just enough. Corner kick.
Great job, Agachi, because Acosta was in.
There come the subs. Pablo Villamizar. Cots to the line, and we'll put it out for a throw-in. 14 to play. Eastern Florida will improve to 9-4 and 5-2 in the conference with the two games against Broward left. And Silver Storm, if this scoreline holds. We'll drop to 0-9 for the season.
And look at that intensity at 6-0. You can tell the players from Eastern Florida are not going to give up anything cheap. You see Matt McLennan right there just trying to clear everything. He doesn't want to foul right outside the 18. You're right, though. It's going to be a very interesting finish with the way the bracket's setting up now. Eastern Florida has to play two away games. So one home, one away, right?
Correct. And Broward playing Daytona State in a big one tonight down in Pembroke Pines. Boy, here's a shot from distance. It was very ambitious. And it's going to lead to a goal kick.
I'm going to check the ESPN ticker, see if we have a result on the Daytona
game. The WEFS ticker.
Yes.
All right, John Bober, get to work. Invent that one. There, the reinforcement comes in. I have a feeling that Alex Alexis Knight will be done. Nate Grant comes in. Now, remember, Adolfo Peraza was in at left back. That may move Grant forward, where in high school that's where he played, and that's where he seems to be right now.
Yeah, no, he's and that's a good sub. I said anywhere around the 10-minute mark, that's when you want to start making subs and permanently just leave him out. Save the legs.
He's already got the hat trick. Velez. Everybody stay behind the ball here. Bradley Franklin giving chase. Turn from Farrow. Snuffed out again by Grant. Oh, Orsi Dodomo waiting on that one, had it taken off his foot.
Yeah, you gotta come get it.
And now Kautz switches it. Grant with Cisse in front. Grant will put it off the keeper, should be a corner kick, it is. Coming up on the 10-minute mark, 6-0 the score. Hat trick from Alex Alexis. Goals also for Morsi Dodomo, McCall, and Cisse in this one. Captain's armband tonight. Actually, it was the substitution penny. Is Salgado back on? Got to rotate these guys here.
Yeah, Salgado would love to.
Thought McLennan was coming off a second.
To get a goal, another chance for Eastern Florida.
Held into the attacking third, blistered by McLennan there.
Yeah, Alex with a good look from about 40 out. Takes a touch and lets one go. It's a good way to test the goalkeeper. Although he's been tested the whole game.
Matt heads it forward.
Once again, take a look at this corner. Try to go far post, deflection, ASS, and now Alex just tees one up. That definitely had the distance. And you can tell right away, you can hear when you make good, solid contact with the ball.
Get them laces on it.
It feels good.
Under 10 to go, Alec Hilburn, there's a shot from distance right into the gut of Gucci. Happy to take shots from distance all night the rest of the way. Dropping back, Villamizar. Mauricio Rodriguez from Aragua, Venezuela.
And now ASA is going to be content with just hitting the ball long, trying to find somebody on top. Cisse. They're not going to try to build in the middle and take their touches. They're going to go direct. They know they're running out of time. So if you're Eastern Florida, this is when you got to keep Tarkowski, somebody in the back deep, an extra 10, 15. So you play three in the back, two marking, and then the last one?
Well, listening to you, Tarkowski going to go for the throw.
Exactly the opposite.
Hey, who's the coach?
Exactly.
Falls into the box, cleared off the 6-yard line.
Well, in his defense, he left two players in the back, so now he's got to get back.
Catching up is Farrow. Mario come back. Wait for numbers to support. Sent to the far side, and it's intercepted. Peraza.
Oh, this is trouble right here.
Cisse able to catch it up. One-on-one off via Mizar. Goes to the outside. Cisse will drill it into the stratosphere. It's actually into the night.
He had Matthew Kotz wide open in the box for Eastern Florida.
Sophomore Cisse.
Definitely a dynamic player. You can see he's wearing that
captain's armband right now.
And also that tape job on his knee. He went to that last collision. That's what I say, he's got to be careful because he was nursing that injury from the previous game.
Matthew Kotz, freshman. McLennan got the start tonight. Leaving it back into the box. Oh, and it's missed. Thought that was going to be a goal. Long run up there.
Nate Grand with a great chance to make it seven. Nobody around him. He could have actually taken a touch and put that one away.
Nice intervention by Grant. Now going on to the offense, and now we'll have to concede the throw.
Sometimes like that one, Jeff, it looks so good that you don't want to take a touch.
Just want to let her fly.
Hit it. Yeah, hit it one time.
Nicely laid back.
Look at that great ball on the ground, and you want to hit it one time. And, of course, being a left-footed player, he turned his hips a little bit more. He could have made good contact with the right foot. He chose to go to the left, and that's why he's body turned, not giving him the best angle towards the goal.
Gucci, approaching 5 minutes to go. It was a handball. Well, it has been all Titans tonight since the third minute. And Orsi Didomo took the dog for a walk. Just placed, got around a defender and placed the ball into the net.
Oh, yeah, that was nasty finish amongst two defenders. Keeper came out. He won the solo effect. But just the way Eastern Florida and their coaching staff, led by Oliver Twelvetree, just planned it tonight. You need to be precise. You need to be matter of fact when it comes down to the finishing clinical, and they did that.
Final five, Peraza pushing off and getting the turnover. Now we'll play direct the other way over the top for Cisse, and way out of his box is Velez to guard against any shenanigans. McLennan defending in the center. Look, Barafranca here on the left side. ASA has not asked many questions tonight of this back line. And that will be scuffed out of play by Acosta. And here comes a substitution. Here, a change for Oliver Twelvetrees. McCall may come back on, close it out.
Lewis Fogg leaving the field. Yep.
Give
one
him
call.
A,
come back
give him
in.
A little rest.
Yeah, this is when you're going to start seeing some of the starters be taken out. And that, well, at least he's got that little rotation going as far as keeping the fresh.
Yeah, doesn't really have anybody available. The bodies to take them all out,
yeah.
Right?
Yeah, it'd be great if you can just take him out and don't rotate him anymore. But you're right. I think he ran out of healthy bodies here, so.
Guys like Juan Parada out for the season with a broken fifth metatarsal. Siegel Knight picked up a knock in the last game. Boy, and Gucci put a head in on this one. Yellow card coming.
A good hit right there. Just right with his shoulder. You were about.
And Acosta.
A clavicle, you know.
And maybe more coming with the descent.
He
goes foot high.
Referee saying he was going cleats up. Referee comes out. The oh yeah, that's definitely. See, he's cleats up, and
did
he actually
did he get
goes
the wrong guy
in through his chest. for the yellow. No, you got the right guy, but
I thought 23 was the one. A bigger concern is Joseph Gucci, who is there on the 18, and Oliver 12 trees.
And Gucci, see, the reason why he hit the ball is because he's outside the box. So knowing that he's outside the 18, he goes for the header.
Yeah, so did 23 commit the foul? If he did not get the yellow.
No, I think the yellow he gave it for descent.
Okay,
to,
gotcha.
That was number 10, Caleb Acosta, I believe.
So he was trying to defend his player.
Correct.
Sure.
And that's why the referee said no, absolutely. There was contact. He went cleats up.
He gets his yellow too. Okay. So Farrow will come off. So back-to-back yellow cards. So two of your top players off here in the last 3.5 minutes. I hope everybody's okay.
Take a look at this different angle here. And it's one of those just awkward situations. Now 23 right there, there's really no intention. If he would have had the intention, he would have fully extended, and then you really do some damage. You can tell at the end, even though his leg was out, he kind of pulled it in a little bit, which, you know, you do not cause that much damage. But if you fully extend and you flex that quad and you lock your knee, then you're talking about some serious repercussions there.
Not the win there from Bradley Franklin. McLennan serving it in. Salgado on his right foot now. We've tripped up. Not going to get the call.
Yeah, Johnny taking too long. You got to take the shot from there. And as you mentioned earlier, you're not going to get the call at 6-0 unless it's just
egregious, yeah.
Completely, you know, obvious.
McLennan. Defense comes back. McCall on Schachtel. And intercepted. Well, the lads from Eastern Florida State College have given an all-out effort tonight, and you know that Oliver 12 Trees has to be very pleased with that aspect of this game. Not to mention the score line. Salgado can't get it clear. Stepping up was Tworkowski. Just over 2 minutes to go, 6-0. Dolfo Peraza. We'll wait for somebody to put the pressure on. Kautz will let it fly, and he's off target wide right. And I'm sure he'd like to have that one back, looking for his first goal of the season. Under two to play, all Titans tonight. End-to-end soccer for the better part of the last 20 minutes. Wide open. Rodriguez. Mosquera. Merritt. Bamizar back defensively. And here is Redondo. Just no answers tonight for ASA College. Velez clears it all the way to the other end. Tworkowski with the header. 1 minute to go. Oh. Well, step over there from Grant. Falls in the box. And trouble clearing it here. Franklin. McCall. Service. Stepping back, Peraza. About a half minute remains. Square to McLennan. This is how you see out a game here. Kautz service. Velez spills it. And a fortuitous bounce back to the keeper. Cisse could have pounced. 20 seconds to go. ASA trying to break up the shutout here. They'll have a chance at it. Got to move quick. 10 seconds. Duque. Last shot. Last kick of the game. McLennan. Final buzzer and final score, 6-0. The Titans move to 9-4 and 5-2 with a thorough domination of ASA College of Miami. And the season is over for the Silver Storm, and two big ones left for the Titans. And they've set themselves up a nice table to go down to Brevard Friday and back on Sunday for sophomore day. McCall, the captain, with a great effort tonight. All hands on deck coming off the loss and did what they needed to do. 6-0, this is how it happened, and it started in the third minute. Danilo Orsi-Dodomo escorts it into the net. It was 1-0. Then Grant gets chucked down, but that wasn't what led to a penalty. Is right here, Alexis, who would factor into the game later on in a big way. McCall's second goal of the year, that via the PK in the eighth, was 2-0. Then Alexis got just enough of a touch. 3-0 in the 17th minute. No scoring again until the 57th. Now into the second half, Alex Alexis getting around the edge. And put that one into the net eventually. It was 4-0. 3 minutes later, watch Alexis here from distance and hit the side netting. 5-0 on a hat trick, and then Yaya Cisse off the post and puts the finish in. 64th minute goal, and the Titans see out the shutout. A clean sheet for Joseph Gucci and Bryce Notardonato, the keepers, and a really impressive effort for the back line of Nathaniel Grant, Lewis Fogg, Oren Twerkowski, and Matt McLennan, also Adolfo Peraza coming on late. And let's send it downstairs. Eddie Rodriguez is with the victorious head coach, Oliver Twelvetrees.
Thank you, Jeff. Here we are with the captain, McCall, and the coach, Oliver Twelvetrees. Good win, just the way you planned it. A big fat donut in the back, you need to shut it down. But the important thing, you score some goals going forward.
Yeah, it's a good performance. You know, the boys need to relax and enjoy the football a little bit. And I think, you know, when the first couple of goals went in, we saw some free-flowing football. And it was good to see the captain get off the mark here and get a couple of goals tonight.
Right. We gave you the second goal because he was such a great strike. You know, soft, great penalty kick. By the way, the first one and the second one, you chipped cheeky little flick to the far post. We give it to you. Your thoughts on the goals?
I'm definitely taking them both. I don't think I've ever had a brace in a game, so it's good to get the two goals, help the team out, and get the result we needed.
Coach, going forward, we talk about the different possibilities during the broadcast, so now you really got to go away, and then you come back home. You need a little bit of a result to go through. It puts it a little bit tough situation because of Monday losing the game.
Yeah, you know, it was a tough result on Monday. You know, things didn't go away, but, you know, we showed the resilience and showed the heart and character of the boys to bounce back and put in a good performance like we did tonight, and we're ready to go on Friday. You know, game on Friday, we know we got to go down there and get a result, and we know if we go down there and get a result, we put ourselves in a great situation to go through and make the playoffs and go for another run.
Greg, how are the boys feeling practice? You know, they know today it was a good clinical finish for them. You know you couldn't give anything in the back. How are the boys during practice, and how they feel going towards the playoff?
I think that was a great win. Give us a bit of confidence going into the next two huge games. We didn't do too much in the practice cycle. We got a lot of games coming up in short periods of time, so it's mainly just recovery, rest. But the squad's good, so we're definitely feeling better after that.
You know, he brings a good point. So many games in such a short period of time. What do you do going forward? Are you a little worried about the depth of your bench right now because you have some injuries?
Yeah, you know, we do have a few injuries, but some boys really stepped up today and showed that they can, you know, Matt Couts on the wing and centre forward, you know, really led the line well today for us. And Alexis got a couple of goals, and, you know, Alex and Matt McLennan, you know, came in and did great as well. So we know we've got guys that can come off the bench and make a difference for us. And, you know, as long as we got Big Macca leading the way, we'll be all right.
Yeah, well, great win. I would say definitely tactical discipline was the name of the game tonight. You got it done going forward, the goals, and then you had a shutout. Good win. Jeff, right back to you in the booth.
Thanks so much, Eddie. So let's change the official scoring. We said Alexis had a hat trick. Not the case. A double brace for McCall. So that third goal will give the credit. The official score overrules Radcliffe and Rodriguez. So there you go. So McCall with a two-goal performance. Alexis as well. And it adds up a 6-0 win over the Silver Storm. For Eddie Rodriguez, our producer Brian Foster, director John Bober, and our entire WEFS-TV crew, I'm Jeff Radcliffe saying so long, Titans, a 6-0 winner. Good night.